Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? The equinox occurs at 1331 Universal Time on September 22nd. So with the equinox, we not only get things like Chicago Henge, where the sun will appear straight down some of those east-west city streets in the evening as the sun is setting, because the sun is directly towards the west. We also get the beginning of autumn for the Northern Hemisphere. And in so doing, there's a number of changes that are going to be occurring. We obviously get earlier and earlier evening sunsets throughout the course of the season itself, which means that we get to go outside with our telescopes sooner, which many of us are like, yay! The other thing that happens is that there are a number of ways that the sky changes, which I think are really interesting. So let's look at, well, we got the summer triangle right now that's almost directly overhead. So Vega and Deneb and Altair down here form the summer triangle. Arcturus is over in the west, which will be setting first because it follows the sun towards the west. But let's see how that sky changes. So this is about 8 o'clock at night for me. So about an hour approximately after sunset on the 22nd. Now I've got the ecliptic line brought up here so you can see where Jupiter and Saturn are. And then Mars is just barely rising because it's nearly at opposition at this time. But if we go ahead a month, you can see how number one, the ecliptic kind of gets a little higher in the sky. Number one, the planets are moving this way. The summer triangle is moving towards the west. We go another month ahead and Saturn and Jupiter look like they're almost set. But remember, things are getting darker a lot sooner. So we can actually back up an hour and they're still up. They're still there. But look how much closer they are together now in November. They're going to get really close the following month too. So Mars is now well past opposition, but it's still okay to see because the diameter is 16 arc seconds. So still small, Mars is always small, but it's smaller than it was when it was at its closest on October 6th, but it's still big enough to see. So still be looking at Mars now. And if we scoot ahead right up to the edge of the winter solstice, we can see how Mars will be almost directly overhead. And look at how that ecliptic is so much higher now. It's practically overhead. And if we back up another hour, we can see Jupiter and Saturn are right on top of each other. On the 21st, on that solstice, they're going to be like within 0.1 degrees of each other. You'll be able to see both in the same telescopic field of view, not even just binoculars, but telescopic field of view. So that's going to be a cool thing to see. Uranus also reaches opposition this season. I will talk a little bit more about Uranus and Neptune in an upcoming episode. But I'm going to back up again, and I'm going to show you what happens now also with the galactic equator, because the galactic equator is kind of running this way. So if you bring up your sky viewing options window in the marking section right underneath where ecliptic is, you can see galactic equator is right here. So if you click on that, it brings up a line, and I have mine colored gray so we can see it there. And it shows you where the Milky Way is running in the sky, which is helpful because that's where a lot of our objects that we want to try to look at are. Except in the spring when we're trying to look for galaxies. But for those deep sky objects, they tend to be pretty much in that area. So if we click on our labels and markers, you can see how a lot of them are clustered right along that line. Now, the interesting thing that I'm going to show you is how we move from having been looking at towards our the center portion of our Milky Way. So we've got M22 down here, right by Sagittarius, and M7, and those are really kind of like right at the core of our Milky Way. But I want to look a little ways away from there. So if we kind of use our measuring tool, we can see how M39 is about, what is that, maybe 80, 90 degrees or so. It's a little hard to tell because that's not really wanting to show me it easily there. Yeah, so about 90 degrees away. So that's a good place to be looking to see what's going to happen as we're shifting. And the other direction that we're going to be looking relative to that in just 3 months' time. So watch this. I'm going to leave that 90 degrees up there too, so you can see. But M39 is right here at the edge of this, okay? So if we go ahead a month, we can see how, you know, we lose a little bit of stuff down here. But now look how this is tilted, because previously, whoops, we had this was running almost, southwest towards the north northeast, but then just even 1 month ahead, it's gone now southwest to northeast. Now watch this, it goes almost east west just by looking at it 2 months later in November. And then if we go all the way up into December, we can see how we've gone now almost the complete opposite direction. It's done almost a full 90 degree turn in the sky in just 3 months, from that south southwest region to west northwest over to east southeast. Now look at where Messier 39 is. It's way over here. If we went another 90 degrees, we'd be looking almost the complete opposite direction, right? And if we go ahead in time, just an hour or two, look what happens again. It moves even more. Look at where M39 is at. It's really low over in the northwestern sky. And if we pull our angular tool here, I'm going to pull it like this so we can actually see where it's at. And we go about 90 degrees or so. Look at that. We're looking in just above where Orion is at in the winter circlet area. And that's the opposite direction. We're looking 180 degrees away from the center of our galaxy. Now we're looking completely opposite, out from out towards the outer arms of our galaxy. So I think that's a really interesting look at just in 3 months' time, you can see how that shift really occurs. And if you want to watch that, you can even kind of see that throughout the course of a night, although you'd have to stay up all night to be able to do that. Probably in early October would be maybe a good time to do that. But we can still watch that through, and if we want to just watch it in the evenings, we can see that from September through December. So that's what's going to be happening for the next couple of months. I will obviously have updates for you. And unfortunately, the sky is difficult to see for a lot of us, especially here in the US, because we've not only had some hurricanes happening in the southeastern part of the United States, but then there's all the wildfires that are happening over in the western part of the US, which have, due to the jet stream, been brought across most of the United States. And I've even seen some people mention how those the haze from the smoke of those wildfires is even affecting people now over in Europe. So obviously we're all affected by this, but we want to keep our thoughts with the folks who are actually right in the path of the hurricanes and also dealing with the fires. Hopefully everyone stays well and stays safe. So when you do get an opportunity and the sky clears for you some, I hope you'll go outside and take a look and see what is happening up above you and what we have coming in the season ahead. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.